Hey there, this is Pastor David with your One Vision Word of the Day. So your humor is this today. If having low self-esteem and a low self-image was an Olympic sport, I'd probably get bronze. All right, well, I hope that's not the case, that your esteem is so low. Confidence is the word that God wants us to talk about today. And the scripture we're going to use is found in Psalms 118, verse 9. It says, "It is better to trust in the Lord than to depend upon people. It is better to trust in the Lord than to depend or be confident in human leaders." Now, depend is another word, of course, for confidence. When you depend on something or someone, you are placing a certain amount of trust in that person to uphold their responsibility. This is a sour area for some Christians because we many times put our trust in people who let us down, and then we decide to stop trusting all people and that all people are not good enough to be trusted. We are social beings and we always want to place everything about position and what we have to choose or who's the most important. It reminds me of this funny story of a son who came to his dad and asked, "Dad, what's the difference between confident and confidential?" The dad replied, "Well, you are my son. Of that I am confident. Your friend Tommy is also my son, and that is confidential." Okay, maybe that was too much information. All right, not the best testimony, I know. Just laugh a little, it's okay. I know that sometimes real things happen to all people, and even in Christian lives sometimes. So you can see why people don't want to trust other people. We need to get back to the truth of this verse, which says not to put our confidence in man or even in human leaders, but put all our trust in God. Put your confidence in God today. Please don't get out of this that Pastor David said, don't trust anybody. On the contrary, learn to trust God's ability in people to surprise you, even though you think they may fail you. But most of all today, put your confidence and your dependence completely on God's ability not to fail. Because I promise you, He cannot and He will not fail. And remember, you're blessed to be a blessing.